The mysteries of Yahweh's kingdom have been hidden from nearly all who have ever lived. He hid his truth from those who sought a different image of his character. In Psalms chapter 25, verse 14, we're told, Yahweh's hidden counsel is with them that fear him, and he will give them to know his covenant. Fearing him is fearing to not be found walking in agreement with him. It is fearing to not be found in his favor. It is fearing to transgress against his will. In Deuteronomy chapter 28, we're told, and it will be that if you will diligently hearken to Yahweh Elohim's voice and hedge about and do all of his commandments which I command you to do this day, that Yahweh Elohim will set you on high above all nations of the earth. He goes on to list his blessing promises for doing so. Then he tells us in verse 9, Yahweh will establish you as his holy or his set apart people as he has sworn to you if you will hedge about Yahweh Elohim's commandments and walk with him in his pathway. And all of the people of the earth will see that you are called by Yahweh's name, and from you fear will be upon them. He commanded Israel to go forth and to conquer and to destroy all who did not agree to his terms and conditions. He did so because our life here in the flesh is supposed to be about helping him build his eternal family. Allowing for that which leads to eternal death to exist in our midst works against him increasing his family. If Israel had walked or continued to walk with him in his righteousness, then the rest of the world would have seen his glory, and the fear of the Most High would have flowed out from us. Then he went on to say in verse 14, you shall not turn to the right or to the left of all of the words which I command you to do this day, to follow after other aliens which are not known by his word, to serve them. It will be that if you will not hearken to Yahweh Elohim's voice, to hedge about all of his commandments and his statutes, which I command you to do this day, that all of these curses will come upon you and overtake you. Then he goes on to list the curses that will befall us if we do turn to the right or to the left of that which he bid for us to do. In these curses, he tells us in verse 64, Yahweh will scatter you among all people from the one end of the earth to the other. And there you will serve other Elohims, which neither you nor your fathers have known, even of wood and stone. Why is it that you refuse to believe that he has sent you into the captivity? Why is it that you refuse to believe that he has given you over to believe into lies that will not give you eternal life in his family? Why is it that you refuse to believe that he is pure righteousness, and that only that which is in agreement with his pure righteousness will inhabit eternity with him? Yeshua told his disciples in Matthew 13, and the disciples came and asked him, why is it that you speak to them in parables? He answered and said to them, because it is given to you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but it is not given to them. It was given to his disciples because they were following him. Why is it that you think that it is given to you to know if you are not following him on the path that he walked on? He walked with his Father in perfect obedience to his word. In verse 12, it is given to those who hold Yahweh's word, and they will greatly abound. But those who do not hold his word, that which they hold will be taken from them. Therefore I speak to them in parables, because seeing they do not see, and hearing they do not hear, neither do they understand. And in them, and in those of you who are not holding fast to Yahweh's word, and his true image that his word testifies to, the prophecy of Isaiah is fulfilled, which says, hearing they, or you, will hear, and you will not understand, and seeing you will see, and you will not know. You do not know the mysteries of Yahweh's kingdom, because he has given you over to believe into lies. They were sealed until now, except for to those who came to Yahweh's call out from the captivity. They were hidden in his word. He told us in Isaiah chapter 28, Yahweh's word exists to you, precept upon precept, precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line upon measuring line, here a little or an insufficient amount here, and there a little, an insufficient amount there, in order that you could walk and stumble backwards, and be broken, and snared, and be taken captive. But now his temple is finished, and he has revealed that which was hidden in his word. In the previous two verses, he told us in verse 11, because with mocking lips and with a different tongue or a different way of speaking, he will speak to this people through his servant. He has sent me to you in the prophecy of Elijah to tell you that which is recorded in his scriptures of truth. He will say through his servant, this is that which will give rest to the weary and give them comfort. This is the place to escape the toil. Yet they will not be willing to hear you. You will not hearken. I have told you for 3+ years now, and I've been crying out for you, if the image of Yahweh Elohim that I have been sent to testify to, which is the image that his word declares, is the true image of the Elohim of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, then stand with me in standing with his righteousness, and he will deliver you into the millennium. And I have been speaking that if you want to hold on to the image of the G-guy whom you serve and worship as the true image of Yahweh Elohim, the Elohim of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, then prepare to die. Soon I will be mocking you when you cry out to your G-guy whom you serve for deliverance and from the coming deliverance from the coming time of affliction. Like Elijah mocked the servants of Baal, I will be mocking you by telling you that maybe the reason why your Elohim is not answering you is because he is asleep, or maybe he is on a journey far away, or maybe he is off relieving himself or masturbating. Yahweh Elohim told us that at the time of the end, he would declare that which is hidden in his word to us. In Daniel 10, then he said, "Do you not know from where I have come to you? Henceforth I will return to devour, to consume those with the prince of Persia. And when I go forth, behold, a prince or a head steward will come to you from Greece. Truly, at this time, I will declare to you that which is recorded in the scripture of truth." In other words, he will reveal and restore all things like our Messiah also prophesied that one would be sent to do at the time of the end, in the spirit of Elijah, the prophecy of Elijah. "And there is not one that seizes or restores with me in these things except for Michael, my head steward. He has sent me to you, fulfilling an incredible volume of prophecies to prove to you that I am this Michael. Why don't you believe his word, the testimony of his word? Why is it that you refuse to come out from the captivity? I told you why in the last video. It's because you love the captivity instead of loving the true image of our Creator. You are enemies to his true righteous character. You call that which is good before his eyes evil, and you call that which is evil before his eyes good. And you are soon going to be purged from before his face if you continue in your rebellion to his righteousness. The mysteries of his kingdom have been spread out before you in these videos in order for you to taste and see that his righteousness is good. The choice is yours to make. You can choose to hold on to the image that your wicked, uncircumcised, rebellious hearts desire, and dying you will die. Or you can choose to turn from your rebellion to his true righteous character, whom I stand with, and live. Choose life so that you and your seed may live. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim.